I'm in the garage here, right in front of our 350Z project. We've swapped an LS into it and been transitioning it from a street car into a race car. And one part of that transition has been the car's dash. So right after we swapped the car at the LOJ conversions shop, we were running still a stock 350Z cluster. But when we transitioned to a race car, we realized that we were leaving a lot on the table by still using a factory dash in the car. That's why we put in this AEM CD-7L carbon dash, which is one of the many different digital dashes you can buy these days for racing. There's a bunch of companies that make them, but we chose the AEM specifically because, well, we poked and prodded them all and decided this one was the best fit for our car. Not only is the CD-7L carbon super light, but I actually picked it because it had the best display on the market, at least based on what I could tell walking the halls of SEMA and just looking at every dash I could find. This thing is like a spotlight light in your face, which isn't ideal in a dark shop like this, but is awesome out on track in the daylight because unlike a phone screen or even a factory dash, it is really easy to see at all times, even in direct sunlight. So really the screen and the ruggedness of the enclosure sold me on the CD-7L. So how did we install it in the car? Pretty easy. It's basically got one plug on the back, feed it power, ground, and a CAN bus connection to the car's PCM, and it works just like the factory cluster. We used the AEM setup wizard to pull in our data sources, set them up, lay out a couple different layouts, and we were back in business with all the functionality, the factory dash, and this neat, compact, durable platform. But that's not really why you put a digital dash in a race car. It's not just an easier way to display the same data. Digital dashes are a fantastic tool to help you get faster and make your car more reliable. So the L in CD-7L means that this is the logging model, which means it basically has a ton of memory inside and is logging everything that happens in your race car at all times. So if you do have a failure or something goes wrong or there's a sputter or you don't quite know what to do with that part on track, you can pull everything up in the AEM data software on a computer and see exactly what everything on the car and you were doing at that spot on track. And we found that to be a fantastic tool to get faster and to find teething problems as we sort out this fresh race car build. So not only does the logging dash log, it also means that you're not set on just a couple fixed gauges with dials and numbers like this. You can make a bunch of different layouts. I think it supports like 5 screens at the ready. You can toggle through at any time. But that means when we're on the dyno, we'll have a screen that's just every single important number on the car so we can keep an eye on the drivetrain. But while we're on track, we'll actually minimize that and go to a screen that focuses on lap time and only just a couple key bits of data, and everything else the dash watches with alarms. So it logs, it can set alerts, you can set different screens. It can also pull in other data sources. We've got a AEM vehicle dynamics module as well as a 22-channel CAN sensor module in the car. Those connect with CAN bus just like a factory PCM using a protocol AEM calls AEM Net. And that basically just means that you can add a bunch of sensors without having to add a bunch of wiring to the dash. Everything just daisy chains together with a couple wires. So that's how we're adding a couple sensor connection sensors. We've got an oil temp probe here. We've got 4 shock travel sensors that we're going to be putting on the car. And all of those can plug right into this dash and be logged in the same software everything else in the car is locked. So it basically means that instead of a bunch of disparate sources of data, a bunch of different data loggers, you can put everything into one piece of software and then start analyzing it every time you come off track. And we found that it's been a pretty powerful tool just with what we were feeding to the factory dash, and we think it's going to be even more powerful with the new sensors we're adding. They also make a CD-7LG as well as some 5-inch models too. Those are called CD-5s. The LG adds GPS to the dash. Now, we didn't go for that model because we have a vehicle dynamics module in there. That actually brings a really, really high resolution GPS module to the car, as well as roll, pitch, and yaw sensors. So that way we can really accurately model what the car was doing on track and make decisions based on it. So I'm also a big fan of the predictive lap timing functionality built into the CD-7L. It's not the most advanced way to analyze data. You need a laptop for that, but it does a really good job with just a graphical bar that's green or red. That shows you basically if you're going faster or slower in each segment, each lap. And that's a fantastic tool to try and figure out what you're doing right and what you're doing wrong when you're out on track. Okay, so let's talk downsides on this AEM dash. Aren't too many downsides as much as things you should know before you buy. And the first is that it is not as user-friendly as some of the other dashes on the market. If you were hoping for an easy setup wizard that takes 3 clicks or a smartphone app that automatically sets up your dash for you, you're not gonna find that in the AEM dash design software. What you will find is one of the most comprehensive pieces of software for setting up a dash we've seen at a consumer-oriented product. You're going to have to read the instruction manual. You're going to have to set aside 3 or 4 hours in your garage to pull in all your data inputs, format them correctly, set their logging, all that. But what that All this complexity means that you're not hemmed in by some of the predefined layouts or templates that some of the other dashes come with. I mean, you can have 50 metrics on one screen all packed in if you want. You can change things layouts down to the pixel. You can have it perform real-time calculations on the fly. You can have it combine or separate different data sources on the fly to create inferred data or computed numbers. It is amazing how powerful this thing is. And if you're willing to put in the time to set it up, which thankfully I was, you can do some really, really cool things with it. And it's really cool to see AEM hasn't put any guardrails up around you. Now, that means that you can royally screw things up and have to spend a bunch of time fixing things if you don't really understand what you're working on. But as long as you look at the user guides and the instruction manuals, you'll be able to do some really, really cool stuff with this dash. So while it is complicated to set up, AEM has made the dash layouts and the data layouts and collection methods. You can kind of export that all in a shareable file format. So not only does AEM include a million templates with the dash that you can customize to your specific car, but it also means that if you know another AEM dash user or find one online in the user group, that you can actually share templates with each other. And there are even users that are offering to create templates for a fee, just like you'd have somebody build you a website or anything else. So, and we're really excited that we have this much power in a consumer-oriented product. So yeah, that's about it for the CD-7L carbon dash from AEM that we've got in our 350Z project car. I'm gonna go ahead and put this and the sensors back in the car, and we'll see you out on track. If you wanna learn more about this or any other AEM product, we've got a link in the description with more details.
Support brands that support Grassroots Motorsports. Get your chemical solutions from CRC Industries. Visit crcindustries.com to learn more.